Okay, so this was our stream piracy, people. Let's carry on with the longitudinal profile of a river. Now, if you look at the longitudinal profile from a river, you must know that a longitudinal profile, the river was drawn from the source to the mouth. Now, have a look at this here. Here is the source of the mountain, there's the mouth of the river, and the river will flow in that direction. And you must know that this river, we have an upper course in the fluvial cycle, we've got a middle course, and we've got a lower course of a river, as this cartoon shows you of the dog here. An upper course, a middle course, and a lower course. Now, people, what's very, very important of your upper course and your lower course and your middle course is that you must know. Somebody asked me a few minutes ago, what is velocity? I told you it's the speed in which the water actually flows. And if you understand the speed in which the water flows, you will understand the longitudinal profile of the river. Because if you look at the head here in the mountain, you will see that it's a very steep gradient. In other words, we will expect the water to flow much faster here, a higher velocity. And if you have here, look at this here, our gradient is getting more gradual here. So we will expect the river to flow a bit slower here. And here right below, we get the most gentle gradient of all of them. So the river will flow at its slowest here. Now, if you understand that, and people remember, this is very easy. If you know how the river, the speeds differ in these different stages of the river, you will be able to do anything of this, because you'll be able to understand everything, because everything has to do with the speed in which the river flows. Because if you get a steep gradient, it's going to flow faster, you're going to get more erosion. If you get a gentle gradient, then you're going to get, the river is going to flow slower, it can't carry anything anymore, and then all the material is being deposited there. So it's quite easy to understand your longitudinal profile of a river. Now, let us have a look at the cross profile of a river. Now, a cross profile from a river, very important, is drawn from one bank of the river to the other one. Now, remember, you must know the difference between your cross profile and your longitudinal profile. So your cross profile is drawn from one bank of the river towards the other one. Now, let's just have a look at the different cross profiles we can find. In the upper course, as I've mentioned already, this is what the profile, cross profile, looks from one bank. There's the one bank of the river, and it's drawn to the other bank of the river. Now, why does it look like that? The reason, therefore, is if you look at your erosion that you get, it's more erosion will be in downward than lateral or sideways. Because the river is flowing so very, very fast, it can transport larger rocks. And these rocks have a larger downward force, and it's making the river deeper and deeper and deeper all the time. And that's why you get this downward erosion and not such a lot of lateral erosion, sideways erosion. Now, the reason also for that is that, remember that this river is in a mountain, and it's very, very difficult because of the steep slopes of the mountain. I'll show you photos later on. It's very, very difficult for lateral erosion to take place. Now, let's have a look at the middle course. Remember, when it comes to the middle course, then the river has just exited the mountain. And after that has happened, it means that the river can, very important thing that can happen is that lateral erosion can take place, because it hasn't got these steep slopes in the mountain anymore. So the river becomes wider all the time. And when we get to the lower course, it even becomes wider, where your lateral erosion is even more. So this is what your cross profiles look like. Please, you must remember, people, in your upper course, what they look like. Let's just have a look at that again. Remember your upper course, a deeper river, deepish river actually, and the lateral erosion, very, very little of your sideways or your lateral erosion, because the material is much heavier. You've got stones and stuff that will always erode at the bottom. Your lateral erosion in your middle course, that can take place because the river has exited the mountain. Now it can become wider. And then, of course, the lower course, just as it reaches the sea, it is even wider. And remember, in your lower course, the river is even flowing much slower, with the result that deposition actually takes place in this part of the river. But now the problem occurs, but what happens if a river should flow around a bend, or if a river meanders? Now have a look at this beautiful photo that we've got here. Here we see a river flowing here in this direction, right? And here the river is flowing, as you can see, it's flowing around the bend. Now it's very important that you must know that on that side of the river flows much faster. But look at this side of the river. This is a very sharp turn that the river must take on this side. And this means that the water here is going to flow much, much slower on this side. So let's just have a look what happens. So all you must take into account when you are busy studying the cross profile around the bend is that you must take in account, where do I get the faster flow and where do I get the slower flow of the water. Okay, so let's have a look what happens on these two different parts of the river. Firstly, on that side, you will find erosion. Why do we find erosion? Because the water flows much faster. The river flows much faster there. And on this side, you will find deposition. Just have a look at this. Look at the lots of stones found here. The lots of stone and your river sand, everything will be deposited here. And look at the opposite side, where much fewer deposition has taken place. Why? Because the water, the flow was much faster on that side than on this side. So let's see what happens next. That, on this side, where the erosion occurs, is called the undercut. And on this side, where deposition occurred, that is called your slip-off. Now that you've got this, and you must always bear this in mind when you are asked in the exams to draw a cross-section of this, a cross-profile of this river bend. Now let's have a look. We are going to draw a cross-section now from X to Y on this photo. Now, what must I keep in mind? Remember, this is my line X, Y here. Here you see we've got deposition here. Now, if we've got deposition here on this side, then it means that the slope must be much gradual here on this side. And on that side, because we've got erosion and lots of the bank here has been eaten away actually by the river, then it means that we should get a steep slope on that side. Okay, so let's see what a cross profile will be from X to Y. Then it would look something like that. And people, please see where I have indicated X and where I have indicated Y. That's very, very important that these things must be indicated on your cross profile. Have a look at this. Remember that here we said you will have your gradual slope because of your deposition. There we've got our gradual slope. Okay? Look at that slope here. What did we have there on this side? Erosion. In other words, that bank has been eaten away all the time by the water, by erosion. Well, the result is that on this side, we've got a much, much steeper gradient than on this side. So people, you must be able to draw a cross profile of a river bend. And please, people, the most important thing that you must remember when you draw a cross profile around a bend is that you must know in which direction does the river flow. Please, people, you must have a look at the arrows or on the topographical map, try to establish in what direction the river flows. Because if you don't do that, then you are going to turn everything around. Then it means that you're going to have your gradual slope, or your steep slope should be, and vice versa. So please, people, take note of the direction in which your river flows. I told you I would give you, show you some photos of the upper course of the river. Now just have a look at this. This is your upper course of the river. There are the steep slopes, lots of downward erosion, and a narrow V-shaped valley. That is what it looks like. And there we also find a few spurs. Now, people, what I'm doing here, I'm just going through very quickly through this. Actually, this is just all the things that we've mentioned in the first part of our lesson that I'm showing to you what it looks like on the photos. Here we've got our middle course or the mature river. Let's have a look at this. Immediately, you see no mountains. So you've got a more gradual slope. And look at that. Immediately, because there's no mountains, you can have your lateral erosion sideways. So your river can become broad, start broadening up a little bit more. Look at that. We've got a lovely wide valley with a floodplain that we've got there. And meanders. Here we've got our meander, our river bend. Have a look at that. Okay. And then, of course, this is what the cross profile would look like. So this is very important. That is our middle course of the river. So let's have a look at the lower course of the river. Here's a beautiful photo of the lower course of the river, or an old river, as it's always also known. There's the sea. If you see the sea on a map or on a diagram, you immediately know that this must be the lower course. Okay, so almost very flat surface that we've got here. Look at the mouth of the river there. We've got sandbanks. Now, why have we got sandbanks? The river is flowing too slow, and now it deposits the sand here in the old river. That's the reason for the sandbanks there. We've got a wide channel of the river and a floodplain as well. And we've got a meander there. We've got a meander, a river bend there as well. Have a look at that. So we've got a meander also in our lower course. And, of course, that is what the cross profile looked like. Now, people, these photos that I've shown you, I hope that it helped you to understand your three phases of the fluvial cycle. What the upper course looks like, what the middle course looks like, and what the lower course looks like. And you can see how easily it is to apply your concepts on these photos if you just have a look at this and really try to look at the different features of your different parts of your rivers when it comes to photos or diagrams. Okay, so let's just summarize everything that we've done so far. So here we've got the middle course, the upper course, the middle course, and the lower course. And what we've got here, gradient, steep, gradual, almost flat in the lower course. We've got the speed, upper course fast, middle course slow, lower course very slow. Processes, downward erosion, upper course, lateral erosion or sideways in the middle course, deposition in the lower course, and of course your landforms, waterfall and rapids, upper course, meanders and spurs in the middle course, and the lower course, sandbanks, marshes, deltas, and oxbow lakes. People, if you can summarize this, what we've done, like this, I can promise you, and study it also like this with your different topographical maps, then people, you'll understand the concepts and you will be able to apply it on your topographical maps. Now, if we have a look at this diagram, it's the question is, but what's happening here? What's really going on here? And we'll see a lot of old people actually playing on swings and the young people standing outside. What's going here? On here, these young old people, they are in a stage, a previous stage of their lives. They are doing things that younger people should do. So what's happening here is actually that these older people, they have rejuvenated. In other words, they are in a stage younger than they really are. Did you know that rivers, this can happen to rivers as well? So we are going to have a look now at basis of erosion and rejuvenation. Let's just have a look at that. Firstly, you must know your three bases of the your temporary bases of erosion. Three ones on this diagram: a dam, a rapid, and a waterfall. As you can see, is temporary because these things will be eroded away. The dam will be filled up later on, and then eventually we will have our concave graded profile of the river. And then we have also your permanent base of erosion, which would be sea level. And remember, people, it's a permanent base of erosion because no river can erode lower than sea level. Because if a river erodes lower than sea level, it means it must flow upwards somewhere, and which is totally impossible. Now, let's have a look at our rejuvenation, what actually happens here. Remember that we said your upper course, your middle course, and your lower course. Remember, the upper course is also known as the young river, as I've mentioned already. Young river is a young guy running because the river can flow nice and fast. The middle course, or the mature river, the river flows slower. And of course, the lower course, the old river, slows very, very slow. So you can see from old, from young to old, how the speed of the water actually decreases. Now, what is rejuvenation? So rejuvenation, people, is when the river starts flowing faster, it has renewed energy and increased in the erosion. In other words, if you find a river here in the middle course, and that river is flowing very fast, faster than it should actually flow, then that river is actually in the youngest stage than it should be. And then we say that rejuvenation has taken place. It should be in the older stage, in a mature stage, but the river has started to flow faster. And now, very important, the question is, but how does this happen? How can rivers start flowing faster? And I would just like you to refer you to this page that we've got here. Now, here I've got my profile, my longitudinal profile of the river. Now, there are four things that can happen. Just watch. The first thing that can happen is the sea level can drop. See, my sea level drop, and see what happened here. Here, immediately, you see the gradient has steepened. In other words, if the sea level drops, you're going to get a steeper gradient there, and the river is going to start flowing faster. And if it flows faster, what happens? Rejuvenation. Let's see what else can happen. The second thing that can happen is that the land can rise. Now, let me just rise the land on this side. See what happened there? Here on this side. Again, we had there on that side the steeper gradient after the land had risen. So, on that side means that the water is going to start flowing faster. If it starts flowing faster, it's going to start to erode, and then you're going to have your rejuvenation there. And this means, people, where does it happen? It happens there by the waterfall mostly. And this is called the Nick Point waterfall. That is where erosion really, where rejuvenation really takes place. So remember, rejuvenation, people, has to do with your speed of your river that it flows. There are still two other reasons, ways in which rejuvenation can take place that we've got on our diagram here. Firstly, an increase in rainfall. Here we've got the sea level drops, the land rises. Increase in rainfall, obviously, then the river will start flowing faster. And if you've got a fast flowing tributary that joins up with the main river, then we'll also get rejuvenation.